Hello and welcome to the Daily Millwall for Tuesday, the 12th of December 2023. In today's Millwall news, we'll mostly be previewing tomorrow's game against Leicester. So here we go. This is from southernnews.co.uk. Stranger things have happened in football. Joe Edwards hopeful Millwall can pull off a surprise against league leaders Leicester tomorrow. It's 3 defeats in 4 for the Lions and a trip to the league leaders next. Joe Edwards has warned people, he's warning you to not write me off Millwall getting a result from Leicester City tomorrow night. The Lions are enduring a difficult patch of form, and Saturday's 1-0 loss at Cardiff was their 3rd defeat in 4 games. Meanwhile, the Foxes have topped the Championship table since September the 23rd and delivered their biggest win of the season on Saturday when they beat Plymouth Argyle 4-0. Enzo Maresca's side also won 13 of their opening 14 league games this season. Despite the defeat in Wales, Edwards does not believe the game will be a straightforward affair for the league leaders. Speaking after the game on Saturday, he said, "It's an opportunity to play against the teams that so far have been the best team in the league and used to be an established Premier League team. It's an opportunity for the players to show where we're at. Everyone will make obvious predictions because of where we're at and where they're at, but stranger things have happened in football than us going there and getting a result after the difficult ones we've had recently. So we'll be prepared to go there and give our best, but for sure it's a tough game." Millwall last played Leicester in a league game on New Year's Day 2014, losing 3-1 at the Den. The pair have since faced each other in both domestic cup competitions, with the Lions advancing in the FA Cup with a 1-0 win in 2017 before losing 2-0 in the Carabao Cup in 2021. Millwall and Leicester will go head-to-head in the FA Cup again next month. Can't wait. Now, is it possible? Is it for real? I don't know. Is Joe Edwards just being cap? Well, maybe. What's this? LCFC.com, which is Leicester City's official club website. "They have 4 players set to miss the Millwall game," says their manager. Hello, what's all this then? Leicester City will be without Jamie Vardy, Casey McAteer, Kelechi Iheanacho, and Yunus Akgun for Wednesday's clash with Millwall. Leicester City hosts Millwall in the Skybet Championship on Wednesday. The Foxes will be without 4 players for the clash with Joe Edwards' Lions. So there you go. It's confirmed that they will be missing once again. Oh, shit. They were all absent for City's 4-0 victory over Plymouth Argyle. Never mind. They're all missing again midweek. So, yeah. I thought that would be a glimmer of a slimmer of some kind of ray of hope. But they all missed the game on Saturday against Plymouth Argyle, which they won 4-0. So, ooh dear. And that's the thing, isn't it? That is the thing. When you put the reserve players in, they have a chance, an opportunity to show, and they sometimes up their game because they feel important, but they've been asked to play when normally they're sitting on the bench or that they're not even in the matchday squad. So, yes, it looks like that might be harder for us rather than easier. Now, let's get on to this preview in the game. This is the historical record. We haven't played them that many times over the years. About 25 times we've played up at Leicester City. See Filbert Road. When did they build the new ground? Must have been, well, that 2002 game must have been at the new ground though. Filbert Road was the name of the old ground, and then they moved to whatever it's called. What was it called? Walker Stadium? Papa John's Walker Stadium? I don't fucking know. So, as you can see, not a good place to go to as a Millwall fan. You do not see Mill win many times at Leicester. More recently, quite a few times actually. But we first played them in 1947. We lost 5-0. The next game wasn't much better. A year later, we lost 3-0. Our first win came after, what was that, the seventh game. Seventh game away up at Leicester, we won 2-1. That was in 1991, so we had to wait all that time to actually win up at Leicester. So if you went to that game, you were witnessing history. And then we drew, and then we had five losses in a row, including a 3-0, a 4-0, a 4-1, and a 3-1. Ouch! And that was in the 2000s. So we're into 2005 now. We go to 2005 Boxing Day, 1-1 draw. Okay. And then we actually start winning up there. I think this must be when they're in the new ground. Their form's a bit. They went all the way down to League One. League One. They were with us in League One in 2008, which is actually quite a long time ago now, because we're in 2023. But doesn't, when you say the word 2008, I'm thinking that's not that far away, but that is a long time ago now. Was it 15 years? Damn, bro. Where did the time go? But normal service was resumed after that in the championship in 2011. We lost 4-2. And more recently, we lost 3-0 in 2013. That was 10 years ago. But before that, 2011, our best ever result, a 3-0 win. So, yeah. But not only is it not a good place for Mill to go and try and get a win, but it's a place that we go and get heavily beaten often. So the worst, one of the worst results, 4-1, that was almost, was 21 years ago, to the day, 14th of December, 2002, 4-1 defeat. Okay, so, bearing that in mind, let's go on to this and look at whoscored.com. If we go here, if we look on the right-hand side, match facts, Leicester are undefeated in 34 of their last 38 matches in the championship. So they've lost four of their last 38 matches at this level. Millwall failed to win 9 of their last 10 matches. So we've only won one in 10 games. Oof, 10%. 10% win rate. Now these are the last 6 games. Quite a few red cards, weirdly. So including the game we won in 2008. And in 2013, they had a player sent off when we won that game. But you can see, so we've in the last 6, we've actually done quite well. We've won 3, drawn 1, and only lost 2. But those 2 that we lost were a 3-0 and a 4-2. We've only scored 8 goals in 6 games, and we've only conceded 8 goals in 6 games. But the cards, 16, got twice as many yellow cards as we have goals. 16 yellow cards in these games. So let's scroll down past this video and see the table. Obviously, they are second in the table now, because Ipswich played today, and I think they won the game, or they got a point. I'm not too sure. I was listening to the match, so. I see a little stat the other day. Leicester and Ipswich, both of them. This is the best ever start in the championship after 20 games. They got the most amount of points ever. I believe that's just in the championship and not in like de facto Division 2. But that is insane. They have a goal difference of plus 12. They've scored 38. They've only conceded 12. So they've only conceded 12 in 20 games. Yikes. And you can see, if we go, so in home, so in home games so far this season, they have lost 2. The most recent one was against Leeds, they lost 1-0. But they've only conceded 4 goals at home in 10 games. Yikes, that's, wow. Oh dear. And they haven't drawn a game, so maybe that's our play. We should try and play for the 0-0 draw. Now Mills away form, we know it's quite good. 10th. 1-3, drawn 4, lost 3. I only scored 13 and conceded 11. Yikes, okay. And if we scroll down, shall we go? No, let's go to form, overall form. So you can see they're not top because they have lost two of their last six games. They lost at home to Leeds and they lost away to Middlesbrough. So they're not the top form team, they're fifth. But they're unbeaten in their last four. They beat Watford at home. They drew with Sheffield. Well, they only drew with Sheffield Wednesday away. They beat West Brom away. And they smashed Plymouth 4-0 at home. So, yes. And our form is relegation form. Yeah, 22nd in the league. 1-1, drawn 1, lost 4. Damn. Okay. You can see the games here. Leicester's last six home games. In the last six, every game that they've won, they kept a clean sheet in. 3-0 against Preston, 2-0 against Stoke, 1-0 against Sunderland, 2-0 against Watford, 4-0 against Plymouth. The game that they lost, they failed to score. They lost 1-0 to Leeds. Millwall, on the other hand, our away form last time out, obviously, at the weekend, we lost to Cardiff in a game that probably should have been a 0-0 draw. We got absolutely battered at Ipswich. And they took the pedal off the gas, and we managed to get one back. We went up and smashed the worst team in the league, de facto League One team, a zombie team. We beat them 4-0. 2-2 against Watford. Should have won that game. Got very unlucky at the end. Adam Barrett's game. I believe he was in charge of that game. Preston, before that was 1-1 at Preston, and before that is going all the way to October, and Plymouth, that win at Plymouth 2-0. So in those last six away games, two clean sheets against Plymouth and Sheffield Wednesday, but only failed to score in that last game against Cardiff. Obviously, we're wasting time tippy-tapping the ball at the back. We're not being very a bit more direct. Obviously, that's not going to happen tomorrow. I doubt that he will. But there you go. So, moving on to, we scroll down to the team strengths and weaknesses. Do Leicester have any weaknesses? Stopping opponents from creating chances. So they let teams create chances, but those chances aren't taken. Is that what they're saying? And what was the other one? Avoiding individual errors. Okay. Okay. They attempt through balls often. They attack through in the middle. They attack down the left. They rotate their first 11. They're non-aggressive, and opponents play aggressively against them. Ooh. Match forecast. Leicester will dominate possession. Very likely. Leicester will steal the ball from the opposition often. Likely. And we will be shown a high number of cards, likely. Okay. So, moving on to the second part of whoscored.com's page about this game, we go on to the prediction. And what do you believe? So, as we scroll down, we can see. Leicester were at their unstoppable best at the weekend, scoring four times before the hour mark as they romped to a 4-0 home win against reigning League One champions Plymouth. Enzo Maresca's side have won three and drawn one of the last four championship games and can breach the 50-point mark inside just 21 games with a draw here. Millwall were on course for a respectable goalless draw, that's what I said, away at Wales on Saturday afternoon before a late Dimitrios Goutos goal sent the 3 points the way of Cardiff. Joe Edwards is experienced a difficult start to life in senior management. No shit. With the away side having taken just 1 point from their last four championship matches. Indeed. Indeed, indeed. So, they predict Leicester 3, Millwall 0. So there you have it. 3-0. Now moving on to skysports.com, David Pratt, what do they predict? Remember, the game is on Sky, it's live on the red button, it's also on Millwall TV. If you don't have Sky, you can pay £10 to Millwall and watch it on Millwall TV through the website. You've just got to log in with your profile, Pay your £10 and you are away. Now, where are we? Still not there yet. Ah, the standings. I'll show you this. We've gone down a place. It wasn't as bad as I was predicting because Huddersfield lost today. They lost. Were they playing Preston? Yeah, they lost 3-1 to Preston. Stoke drew. They were in the lead and Swansea came back. So they were winning, but they ended up drawing. So they've gone a point above us. They're on 22. We're on 21 points with Huddersfield. We have a game in hand with Huddersfield, but that game in hand is today against Leicester City. QPR playing obviously Wednesday as well. So if they win, there is a chance, if we get heavily beaten at Leicester, that we will drop into the... Well, no, we're not going to... No, we'll drop down to 21st. I don't... unless it's really bad, I can't see us dropping into the... no, we can't drop down, can we? Well, because we have to go to minus 16. Fuck it. Unless we're going to get beat 10-0 at Leicester? Doubt it. So if QPR win and we lose, we'll drop down to 21st. And then, what is it? We play Stoke at the weekend, don't we? So, no, we play Huddersfield. So, so we drop down. We drop down a place. QPR jump above us to 20th. We drop down. Huddersfield drop into the relegation places. We drop down to 21st. And then, if they beat us, they leapfrog us and drop us in the relegation places. Isn't life wonderful? How it all works together. So here we go. Hello, what are you looking at, Specky? Leicester versus Millwall Wednesday at 7:45 PM live on Sky Sports Red Button. Yeah, because it's not the main Sky game on the Sky channel. They haven't moved it to 8 o'clock at 7:45 kickoff. That was among Leicester's most convincing performances of the season against Plymouth on Saturday, and they will be confident of doing something similar against a woefully out of form Millwall. It started so well for Joe Edwards in his first game, but it's been a little galling since. I can't see it getting any easier at the King Power. Home win. Prediction, Leicester City 2, Millwall 0. Yes, it's a loss. It's a loss. All day long, it's a loss. Not only that, but here's the thing. I think we may get lucky that we take them on in a three-game week where we're playing Saturday, Wednesday, Saturday. I'm not sure if they're playing Saturday or maybe they're... If their games have been moved to Sunday, I don't know. But they might take it easy. They might go 2-0 up, 3-0 up, and then just cruise like Ipswich did against us and just see the game out and just pass it rings around us. Just take it easy. Make the 5 substitutions and just see the game out, which might be good for us that we don't get absolutely walloped. But if they wanted to, they could turn the screws on us and just nail us into the ground. So I'm predicting that they'll probably be at least 2-0, 3-0 at half time, and then the second half maybe they get another one. So I'm gonna say Leicester City 4, Millwall 0. It's the realism is setting in now. There's massive problems down there right now. But here's the thing. If we end up winning this game and everyone's, oh, hey, we beat Leicester, hey, we beat Leicester, and then we don't beat Huddersfield, we don't beat Stoke, we don't beat QPR, all day long, lose this game, don't give a fuck about beating Leicester, don't lose Huddersfield, actually we need to win that game. Don't lose to Stoke. We need to win that game as well. And don't lose to QPR because we need to win that game as well. So it would be complete madness if we were to win this game and then lose the next 3 against teams and then we'll find ourselves second from bottom. That would be bizarre. But this has been a bizarre season, a bizarre year, 2023. But yeah, I'm going to go 4-0. And on that note, thank you for watching and goodbye.